Good afternoon, dear students. Today we are going to study our next lesson, The Discomfiture of Shaista Khan. In this lesson, the important points we are going to study: Shaista Khan campaigning, Firangoji Narsal, Shaista Khan in Lal Mahal, a bold plan, and Shaista Khan learn a lesson. So students, let's begin with our lesson. Shaista Khan campaign. In spite of repeated efforts in which he left no stone unturned, Adil Shah of Bijapur could not force Shivaji to surrender. Every Sardar of Bijapur who was sent against Shivaji was defeated. Adil Shah at last gave up the fight and made peace with Shivaji and gave recognition to his independent kingdom. Shivaji thus had peace for some. In the meanwhile, consistent attack from the north had practically renewed Maharashtra. Shivaji therefore turned his attention northwards and carried out raids in the territory of the Mughal emperor Aurangzeb. This enraged Aurangzeb and he sent Shaista Khan, his uncle, to deal with Shivaji and teach him a lesson. Shaista Khan, with huge army of 75,000 men and hundreds of elephants and camels and tens of cannons, marched on Pune. On the way, he captured the towns of Shirwal, Shivapura, Saswat, and finally laid siege to the fort of Purandar. Nothing could stop his advance, but once the Maratha army surrounded him in a mountain pass. The Maratha troops moved very fast on their swift beam-thread points. They also traveled very light. They could traverse the hills and valleys in the shortest possible time on army ration consisting of onions and bajra bread. This type of warfare, perfected by the Marathas, was known to Shaista Khan. Tried to continuous harassment by the Maratha troop, he at last raised the siege of Purandar. Firangoji Narsal. Shaista Khan then continued his march on Pune. First, he captured the fort of Chakan. Firangoji Narsal fought to defeat the fort with great bravery and skill against the army of Shaista Khan. For 2 months he kept Shaista Khan at bay, but he was helpless against the guns of Shaista Khan. Shaista Khan was much impressed with the way Firangoji defended the fort and offered him service with Mughal emperor. Firangoji, however, refused his tempting offer. Shaista Khan in Lal Mahal. Shaista Khan came to Pune and made Lal Mahal, Shivaji's residence, his headquarters. 1 year passed, then another year. Shaista Khan would not leave Pune. On the contrary, his troops would raid Shivaji's territory, destroy crops, and take away the cattle. In this way, he started devastating the surrounding countryside. A bold plan. At last, Shivaji decided to teach Shaista Khan a lesson. In a way, it was a good that Shaista Khan was staying in Lal Mahal. Shivaji knew the place inside out, with all its entrance and exit, its secret passage, doors and windows beside. Shivaji says, with keeping him well informed about the disposition of the Khan's troop. Shivaji therefore decided to enter Lal Mahal one night and kill Shaista Khan. This was indeed a very bold plan. Lal Mahal was so well guarded that even an ant could find it difficult to get through. 75,000 troops were camping outside the palace. No armed Maratha was allowed to enter the town, but Shivaji had made up his mind and there was none who would turn him away from his resolve. Shivaji fixed the date to carry out the plan on the night of 5th April 1663. At marriage procession was passing along the street of Pune. There was music and fireworks accompanied the procession. Hundreds of people dressed in fine clothes were in a procession. Some were in palkins, others in manes, while many more were on foot. Shivaji, with his band of trusted followers, joined the procession to give the impression that they were a part of it. After some time, the procession proceeded on its way, but Shivaji and his men moved away quietly in the direction of Lal Mahal. Shaista Khan was fast asleep at this hour. Shaista Khan learned a lesson. Shivaji made a hole in the wall and entered Lal Mahal. He had no trouble in finding his way about because it was, after all, his own house. The Khan's bodyguard were half asleep. Shivaji followers tied them up. Shivaji went deeper inside. Suddenly, someone rushed at him and with a sword, Shivaji killed him. He thought it was Shaista Khan, but it was his son. There was none a combination. People woke up. Shivaji went straight to the Khan's chamber and took out his sword. Trapped, the Khan started shouting, "Devil, devil!" and tried to escape through the window. Shivaji struck him with a sword which cut off 3 fingers of the Khan. The Khan could have lost his life, but he escaped with loss of 3 fingers only. The Khan jumped out of the window and made for safety. He devised the Khan's troop. Shivaji and his men rushed to cry, "Shivaji has attacked, run, catch him," and start to run themselves. The Khan's troop also started running in all directions. In the confusion that followed, Shivaji and his men made their escape and reached Sinhagad. The Khan's troop spent their whole night looking in vain for Shivaji and his troop. This incident, the fight out of Shaista Khan, he was afraid that if he lost only his fingers in first attack, Shivaji might cut his head off in second. Aurangzeb was furious when he heard of this episode. Shaista Khan lost the emperor's favor and was transferred to Bengal. This was the first serious blow to the Mughal power. Shivaji had successfully ridded that lion in his own den. Gunfire announced to victory and wave of joy went all over Maharashtra.